Let's create a new Power App right here from the SharePoint online list. Notice that at the top in the command bar, we can click Power Apps and choose Create an App. Build a custom app based on your SharePoint list using Power Apps. We're going to name our app to get started, and we're going to simply call this West Inventory and click Create. This will take a couple of moments to build my app. Notice that what has opened is the web version of Power App Studio, which is all displayed in the second tab here in my browser. The app is being saved to my Power Apps collection, and here is the first screen of my Power App. This is great. A quick tour to help us get started. We'll take this tour because it's a quick way to be able to understand how this interface works for the studio. First, on the left, we have thumbnails of the screens, and when we create a new Power App, by default, we get three separate screens. We get a screen that's used for browsing. We see that one here. We get a screen that's detail for one item, and then we get a screen that you can use to create new items or to edit existing items, because the browse screen is really a read-only screen. In addition to the thumbnails, we have this design workspace, the area in front of us, where we're going to create a form just like it will look when it's being used on a mobile device. We have property drop-down menus that allow us to modify controls, and a formula bar. In this case, the formula bar is actually showing us the value of a color, but we can use other formulas that are Power Apps formulas, similar to formulas that we would see in Excel. Other features of this interface include a menu at the top that has tabs, on the right-hand side, we're seeing details for the selected screen. These are the different options that we could use to lay out this screen. And we have advanced options, actions. At the bottom, a zoom slider. That's kind of nice. And the ability to click fit to window. So after we've zoomed, if we are looking at a high level of detail, the quick way back is simply to fit to window once again. If we'd like to preview the app, we have a couple of different choices. First, there's a preview button here that will show us how this app will look in a browser, which is similar to how it will look on a mobile device. Remember that I said that we get three different screens. This is our browse screen. This is our detail screen. And if we wish to edit or create, that's what this screen looks like. So there's the edit version of it. And if we're in our browse screen and we click plus, the empty version of that same screen. So three screens. And this is a preview. And to get out of the preview, simply click the X and we'll be back in the Power App Studio. But we also can launch that app from here because this is where we created it from. Click open. The first time you do this, it will take a little bit longer to load. And here comes our Power App connecting to our data. Looks exactly the same. Browse screen, detail screen, new and edit screen. This Power App is now available here essentially as a view. If I'd like to work rather than with the list view with the app, click open. And I'm taken to webs.powerapps.com so that I can view and use this app.